Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to talk about the Azure Portal. This video is the first of a series about Quick Start on Azure. So would it be because you are a beginner, non-technical, or just because you want to see if that thing works? This series is for you. Every video will be targeting a specific topics, always related to Azure. And if you're new on Cloud in 5 Minutes, yeah, 5 Minutes. So let's get started with the topics of the day, the Azure Portal. There's many ways to control Azure, but one of the easiest way is from the Azure Portal. So open your web browser and navigate to portal.azure.com. You will need to identify yourself using a Microsoft account, those with the Outlook or Hotmail email. If you don't have one, or if you don't have one of those emails, you can always create a new one clicking by use another account and follow the instructions. But for now, since I have one, I will use it. So this is the main Azure portal. So from the top, you got a search bar that will be very useful to search anything inside the portal. And then you got here a command prompt to do some Azure CLI if you need to. Here, if you have multiple subscriptions, you will be able to switch between them using the directory and subscription filters. And finally here, in the top right corner, you got the cog, where you will find the settings, where you could change the language of the portal, the theme, the color, and many different options. To create a new resource from the portal, it's very easy. Click on the big plus create a resource button. That will list all the categories of resources you could create, or simply type the resource you're looking for. So for example, if I type SQL database, I will see a list of all the databases available. To create one, I click on it, click the create button, I need to fill up a little form, and that's it, the resource will be created for me. The subscription you are using probably have a limited amount of credits. To know how much credit is left in your subscription, you will need to check inside the subscription. To do that, from the left panel, click on All Services and then search for Subscription. Here, you click on that, you pick the subscription you need, and there it is. You have the amount of consumptions you have used since the beginning of the billing period. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you will see a linear projections to know how much you will consume by the end of the month. Because we never work alone, it's time to add people inside our subscriptions. So it's very easy to do. We are already in the subscription, so that's perfect. So we need to pick the second option, Access Control, IAM, and click the plus button to add a role assignment. There you have many different roles. When you are in the development mode, it's very frequent to give contributor. A contributor could add any kind of resources, create them, delete them, use them, but the only thing it cannot do is add other members. So you pick that, and then you will choose the email of the person you want to add to your subscription. That person should receive an invite. Check your spam sometime, it falls over there. To limit the credit consumed, don't forget to shut down your VM if you're not using it, or delete any unuseful resources. Of course, you could delete the resources one by one, but a better way will be to delete the parent, so the resource group. Let me show you how. So from the portal, you go in resource group, search for the resource group you want to delete, and click on it. Then from the top, you will have an option to delete resource group. The only thing left will be to enter the name as a last security check, and press the delete button. So all the resources inside will be permanently deleted. No turn back, so be careful. At any moment when you need a little bit more information about the resource you want to use, you just need to go in the resource group and type the resource you want information about. Of course, when I type virtual machine, it will list the virtual machine I have, the type of virtual machine I could create, but if I look in the bottom, I will have documentation, and if I click on that, it will bring me to the Microsoft website about documentation directly on the good page. Of course, I could directly open a new tab and go to docs.microsoft.com. That will open the Microsoft documentation website with tons of information, code sample, and everything you need. And that's it for the portal tour. Of course, it contains many different options. I didn't show everything. I will let you discover them by yourself. In the day-to-day, of course, we'll use something more scripted and code. So you could use Azure PowerShell that now can be installed on any OS, so not only Windows, but of course, Mac and Linux. And of course, you could also install Azure CLI, and of course, that one will be also possible to install on any platform, so Windows, Mac, and Linux. And don't worry, all the URLs will be given to you, but you can always find them in the documentation. I hope you liked this video, and I hope it was useful. Write down your questions or any topics you want me to cover in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you for watching. See you next time.